everybody. My name is Matt Elliott. I'm here at the RV Corral in Eugene, Oregon on Highway 99. Today I want to show you a brand new product from Tiffin. This is a 2023 Tiffin Wayfarer, and the model is called the 25JW. That's the model of this coach. Now, what we're talking about in this coach here is, first of all, this is a smaller Class C, and it's built on the Mercedes Sprinter chassis. So what we have is a vehicle with remarkable safety features and very, very good fuel economy and legendary performance and reliability of the Mercedes chassis. This is what everybody's looking for in the market all the time, because this coach can get well into the high teens for fuel economy. And again, they're just absolutely beautiful to drive. Now, Tiffin uses that Sprinter chassis. Tiffin is also a benchmark quality builder. Everything in this coach is hand-built, and there's a lot of things about it that are unique to Tiffin that you won't really see on most of the other Class C motorhomes built on this chassis. So let's start by looking around the outside. First thing I want you to notice is this has a beautiful full body paint exterior. The Tiffin company builds beautiful coaches with absolutely fantastic paint jobs. They look great for years and years and years. You'll notice that there's a lot of big upgrades on the exterior of this coach. For example, we have the full aluminum alloy wheels. These are not wheel covers. We've got a new Girard power awning. It's a beautiful awning on this coach. It's got a outside TV. So if you want to set up and have a little tailgating or watch a show, you're good to go there. When you look at the exterior storage compartments on a Tiffin product, one of the things that they do throughout their lineup, from the very entry-level coach they build, which none of them are really entry-level, but you have the same kind of craftsmanship throughout their lineup, all the way up to their very high-end buses. And so when you see this aluminum encasing on this compartment door, this is a wonderful construction. It's fully insulated. It never wears out. A lot of coaches have laminated fiberglass compartment doors, and they just, over time, they don't insulate as well and they don't hold up. This also has the hinge to pull it in, and it also has a really positive latch, so it stays closed and keeps the water out. Now, if we look around here, we could see down here, this little guy here, that's an exhaust system for a diesel burner. This uses diesel to heat the coach and heat the water, and it can use electricity or diesel. Most coaches have a propane burner for furnace, and this is a system that gives you a lot of really nice ambient temperatures. It doesn't sound like a blowy, noisy furnace like in my RV. It's very, very quiet. And it doesn't need any propane. This is an electric coach. We'll see that as we go inside. And so that means that I don't have to buy propane to make heat. I can just use diesel or electricity. That's wonderful. Now, if we look around the back of the coach, one of the things you'll notice on the Tiffin product is that we have a full fiberglass enclosure on the back. Most coaches have a wall back here with a seam on the corner. This has an enclosure, and it also has one on the front, which we'll look at. And what that does is it adds a lot of quality to the coach, and it makes it very unlikely to have a water leak in the corners and edges, which is where typically leaks show up. Also, if you look back up here, the roof on this coach is a crowned one-piece fiberglass roof. It's like the hull of a boat on the roof. It's very, very strong. It's not a rubber top. It doesn't have a little piece of fiberglass that's all nailed down all the way around. It's got a full crown, and so it's very, very durable. This is a lifetime coach. It's gonna last, and that's one of the big differences between this and a production class RV. Okay, let's go over here. We take a look. Up here, we have a slide topper awning. We're putting that up there to prevent debris from accumulating on top of your slide. If you have a pine cone up there and you bring in your slide, it doesn't close up right. So it's really nice to have that slide topper on there. And again, here's your water station. All your water systems are internal on this coach. That's really nice. Now, this coach also has a 300 watt solar package on it, and it has lithium ion batteries. So it's like a rolling power plant. It's got the best battery system in the market. got tremendous available solar coming in to keep those batteries reinforced if I happen to be dry camping for a while. Also, this coach has automatic leveling system. So it's easy when you get to camp to hit a button and it'll level and stabilize the coach automatically. It's really, really nice. Now, if you wanted to see up here in the front, this is what I wanted you to see. This has the full cap on the front too. And one of the nice things about their design is that it doesn't hang way out over the cab. If you've ever been in a Class C and you're sitting at an intersection and you look up and you can't see the traffic lights because the rooftop overhangs too much, you don't have that problem with this coach. Also, the whole system is sloped back like this. It's very aerodynamic. It doesn't have right angles that beat into the wind. So that makes a big difference in terms of performance, longevity. You know, that wind can buffet your coach and add to wear and tear over time. And it's a lot quieter when you drive it. So this is really, really nice. Okay, I also want to point out this has a backup camera and side view camera. So when I turn on my blinker, I can see down that side of my coach, which is great. If there's something in my blind spot, I have a chance to avoid that. And if I'm parking parallel, I can get a look at the curb. I love this design to have that feature on there. Let's take a look at the inside of the coach. All right. So let's take a look at the interior on this brand new Tiffin 25JW Wayfarer. Now, this is a really unusual floor plan because we have the slide out with the sofa here, and this is a Murphy bed, and I'll show you that in a minute. Also, we have this workstation, and what they're doing here is they're saying, all right, there are a lot of people that just because they're traveling doesn't mean they don't have some work to do or some correspondence. So this gives you a nice workstation desk. There's actually a couple of folding chairs that go with this coach that you can set down here in front. All the cabinetry in here, it's all very high quality. They make all their own cabinets. They don't buy them. So the highest caliber of workmanship in this coach, all the way through to the top of their lineup, just really, really nice stuff. Now this one has beautiful white cabinets with recessed hinges, and they're soft close cabinets. You see that? They just close like that, and then that goes like that. They have latches so you can pop them into place. And then I got to show you this Murphy bed. So let's take me a sec here, get these cushions out of the way. Okay, now how about that? So now we've got a queen walk around bed in a small Class C. That is impossible to achieve. Very, very few coaches have a design that would give you this feature with such a nice, small, economical, fuel efficient coach. So I love that. It's easy to set up. And then of course, when you are ready to put away your bed, it just goes away easy as pie. And we put that up. So when you're gonna be small, you wanna be versatile, and that's the best kind of design. So we've done that here in this coach, and I like that. Okay, now, right here, we have the multiplex wiring system. I can control everything in this coach right here from this panel. And the multiplex system is great because it's very concise. The wiring is not all over the place. And so tracking down service issues and making repairs and things like that is much, much easier. And they're just a more efficient way to wire up a coach. Now this right here is interesting. This is an all electric 12 volt refrigerator. And the reason I like them is, first of all, since I don't have all the propane stuff in there, I have a much deeper fridge. I get a lot more room. And then the other thing that's really nice is I don't have to turn this off when I'm driving. Normally, a fridge in an RV, either one's on shore power or on propane. Well, that means I can't run it while I'm driving. I gotta get it cold, and then I gotta turn it off and hope it stays cold while I travel. This coach, I can leave the fridge on all the time. So more storage, more efficient. I get to use it all the time. Here's something that you're not going to find on any 25-foot Class C. We've got a Splendide washer and dryer in this design. Everybody would like to be able to wash their clothes and not have to go to a laundromat, especially these days, but none of these small coaches have one. This is the only thing I've ever seen that has a washer dryer in a small coach. That's really cool. Check out the storage in here. We've got adjustable shelving. We've got hanging storage here. And up here, of course, we have our controls for our solar panel and all the other, the generator and the inverter, all the various stuff is up here and it's put away. It looks really nice that way. We look at the galley. You have a beautiful, beautiful solid surface countertop. This little guy is actually a power source. It's already dialed in there. We've got the sconce style lighting, which really makes it attractive. Got a nice big stainless steel sink. And something else I think is kind of cool is this is a pretty roomy kitchen for such a small coach, but I might need a little bit more space. So when I pull this out, I've got a cutting board here. And that's pretty cool. And then this guy here goes back and I've got a drawer under there. So this really has a lot of drawer space and it has an induction cooktop and then we have a convection microwave. So I can use this to nuke things, but I can also bake in this with hot air. And that's a great way to cook. Now, the other thing, we look back here, I'm gonna step back here. Look at the shower. There's no step up for the shower. So, you know, a lot of people talk about this, having to go up over the lip of the shower. Showers are usually quite a bit higher than the floor in a coach. But this one here is right down at the floor. I don't have to, any difficulties getting in. If you have any mobility issues, knees or hips or anything like that, this shower is easy to get in and out of. Plus it's big and it's tall. There's a lot of room in here. It has a retractable shower curtain. These are great. They clean themselves every time you put them away. And also, it's just big. Now look at the whole bathroom. It goes clear across the back of the coach. You got a beautiful porcelain toilet and it's located in such a way that your knees aren't going up against a wall. And then it's got a beautiful counter space. It's got a really nice basin. There's a great deal of storage and it's got a beautiful mirror and it's a lighted mirror. If I turn on that little blue button down there, it lights up all the way around. Also, we have the high capacity exhaust fan here. This is a really important feature because it's going to let me ventilate the coach and get the moist air out and really keep it fresh in here. But it's also got a rain sensor, so it'll close itself automatically if it starts raining. Now we need to take a look up at the front end of this coach. So as we go up here, I want you to notice that this is, it's a Mercedes. This Mercedes has all of the bells and whistles that Mercedes offers. A lot of times you look at coaches and they may not have all the stuff, mainly because of the difficulty of obtaining Mercedes chassis. There's a lot of demand for these things, but this is a fully contented chassis. It has power and memory seats, driver and passenger side. They're heated seats. It has the big navigation system with the big display screen, and it has all of the safety features. For example, if you've never used adaptive cruise control, it's wonderful. When you're traveling, you can set your cruise at a speed, and if the vehicles in front of you slow down, the cruise will slow down automatically, and it prevents you from getting too close or even getting into an accident. There's a lot of other stuff that this coach does. So, just a couple of quick points to refinish on this. We've got leveling, we've got a molded crowned fiberglass top, we've got solar, we've got lithium batteries, we've got multiplex wiring, we've got a diesel generator. I don't know if I mentioned that earlier, but that's really cool. And it's an all-electric coach. You don't need propane. It's a Mercedes and it's got a washer dryer and a Queen Murphy bed. I don't know how they fit it all in here. I'd love to show it to you in person. It's one of the coolest RVs you'll ever see. And if you have any questions, you can come see me or give me a call. I'm Matt Elliott, and you can reach me at 541-954-8495. Thanks a lot. You have a great day.